Unconditional love. We've been taught a lot about it, right? It's something that's talked about a lot in the spiritual community. But do we really understand it? We're going to talk about this today. Sometimes, because of the teaching of unconditional love, in fact, I'm not so certain it is a teaching. In fact, I'm not so certain anything really is a teaching. My belief is that life experience is the teaching. We know that words don't teach, isn't it? Only life experience can help us and guide us to understand more deeply ourselves and others and our relationship to this wider, larger energy or existence or life or God or whatever it is that we want to call it, source, creation. It's up to you, it doesn't matter. So I've written down some things that we may recognize that we're doing in the name of unconditional love, when in fact it isn't. But don't be afraid with this, because some of us make the most innocent mistakes, I believe, in relationship to unconditional love. So we're going to dive into this a little bit now. The first thing to know about unconditional love, sometimes we think it means we have to love everyone unconditionally and completely. And yes, that's kind of true, because it's what we are. But that doesn't mean that we have to egoically love people. What do I mean by that? Sometimes we can feel forced into being a nice person because we're spiritual now, isn't it? Or we can feel forced into doing the right things, whatever those right things are, in relationship to other people. And so sometimes the feeling of unconditional love can come with a feeling of bondage, isn't it? We have to act in this certain way, otherwise we're not unconditionally loving, and then we slap ourselves silly for not being unconditionally loving, as if that's a standard that we have to hold ourselves to. No, we are unconditional love. And so the first thing, the first kind of misconception I want to talk about in relationship to unconditional love is that that doesn't mean that you can't disagree with people. Sometimes, well, not sometimes, me, I went through this for a while. I would feel like I was being forced to be a saint. And I'm no saint. I'm not really a sinner either. I'm just am, in a sense. And maybe in the future, you know, who knows, sainthood might be open to all of us with enough work and effort. But I'm no saint. We're human, isn't it? And people can rub us up the wrong way, and it's okay that they do. And then we can have this idea of unconditional love, meaning that we must love them back regardless of what they do. And that's not necessarily true. Of course, we need to be careful here and recognize that there could be an egoic thing in us in this. If we're holding ourselves to an expectation of being unconditionally loving with people. And that's just surface level, isn't it? It's insincere a little bit. It's inauthentic. We are unconditional love, and that doesn't mean that we have to like and love everyone. But it can mean that we have the opportunity to love every experience that happens. Somebody might rub me up the wrong way. And I suppose point number two, actually, unconditional love just means unconditional forgiveness, really. That's all it means. It doesn't mean I have to be something I'm not. In fact, that would be a subtle form of control, wouldn't it? I have to be something that I don't feel right now in relationship to you, and therefore I have to pretend to be unconditionally loving because you've done this thing that's not perhaps something agreeable with me. It's kind of fake, huh? So that's the second point. It really means unconditional forgiveness. It means not holding on to a grudge, isn't it? Let's say somebody, and I've had experiences of this, and I'm sure you have too, let's say somebody isn't showing up as their best self. Well, unconditional love means, it doesn't mean we don't, we can't be angry at them. Sometimes it's appropriate to be angry. Sometimes it's appropriate to shout. And that's okay too. Sometimes the spiritual ego can try and convince us that it's not, and that we have to be ultra spiritual, isn't it? And this wonderful Buddha stoic statue that graces life. And in fact, that's completely egoic, and in fact, very tight. People probably won't like us if we are that way. And I've made that mistake too, especially in my early journey. So really it means unconditional forgiveness to me for the way that I acted in that situation perhaps, and to them for the way that they acted in that situation. Number three, that doesn't mean though that things won't go wrong. If we're unconditional love isn't some sort of shield the ego can pick up and feel like that might protect itself. It doesn't work like this. Things can still go wrong. People can still hate you. And that's okay. That doesn't mean we have to love them back. But in a sense, you are that love. And if you're willing and open to forgive that action without making it all about us and this self-absorbed personal thing, then we're in that unconditional love, isn't it? We're here to feel it all. And we tend to reject negative experiences, but actually they create such a, I suppose the word maybe might be visceral experience. It makes life so bright. Contrast is amazing. Because if we feel and touch and taste that really low moment, the highs seem higher. There's a difference between celery, the way that celery makes us feel as we eat it, and chocolate. Chocolate's ecstatic, isn't it? All right, it's short-lived, and actually in the long run, celery will make us feel better because it's a great pranic food. But we can, if we have some celery, then the chocolate tastes great, doesn't it? It's naughty, it's fun, and we love it. And so this is kind of the idea of contrast. That person does this thing that's not all that great. Well, that doesn't mean we have to unconditionally love them back. That's control. Kind of, in a way, isn't it? Because it's like, well, let me love you back so that I can get some good favor either with God or you or something, and I can change you or something like this. And it's not like that. Unconditional love is more like unconditional forgiveness of myself and of them in this moment. Four, let's say, and this is the final one, let's say something like that does happen, a disagreement between two people. Well, unconditional love doesn't mean you have to keep them in your life. If somebody is no longer resonating with you on a level, or if somebody is abusive towards you, sometimes we can have this idea that, oh no, I'm gonna become a doormat if I'm unconditionally loving. And it's not like that. There's a misnomer in there, a misunderstanding. It implies that we feel like we have to do something to be unconditionally loving, and that's not fully true either. We are that unconditional love, isn't it? And we can still be that unconditional love away from them. We don't have to keep people in our lives. Sometimes we can feel like God is forcing these people into our lives, and sometimes we can have this idea that God is the one that wants me to change them, or wants me to set them straight, or wants me to keep them in my life, even when it feels really forced and really horrible. You don't have to take abuse in the idea of unconditional love. No, it just means, if they are abusive, it just means forgive. It doesn't mean they have to stay around. Something fell off, that doesn't sound good. It's behind me, I don't know if the camera picked that up. It doesn't mean we have to keep them around and suffer that abuse. No, sometimes we can think there's still something in here for me to learn. No, this isn't the idea of unconditional love. We can still love somebody from a distance. Does that make sense? We can still forgive them and not need them in our lives. And so I kind of wanted to talk about this today. I don't know if I did it any justice. Hopefully it helps, who knows. But I'm sure it would have helped somebody who may be dealing with this idea or concept of unconditional love rather than the reality of it. Of course, down below, should you wish, you can sign up for any of the things down below that are free, like the breathing practice, the community on Facebook or Discord, where you can chat with others about this kind of stuff. The free yoga that's down below. And also there's an awakening coaching form that you're more than welcome to fill out for some private coaching with me. But the coaching itself isn't free, but the application form is. Don't worry, I read all of them, so you won't get ignored. I hope this helped. Have a lovely day or evening or morning, wherever you are. Namaste.